is it brought a new parent with a long-term vision and a willingness to operate locally and invest in the future. Almost immediately, the company and leadership team were challenged to develop a long-term vision and to investigate new technologies. The result of this effort was a steady pace of investment in strategic acquisitions and new product development. In 2013, Continental Motors acquired the assets of Tillard Aircraft Company, adding a successful aviation diesel engine technology to our portfolio. Two MRO businesses, Southern Avionics and United Turbine, were added to the services business in early 2015. The company finished 2015 with the addition of the assets of Danbury Aerospace to bring the Titan line of PMA parts and engines into Continental Motors. Today, Continental Motors is the only aviation piston engine manufacturer with a full line of gasoline and diesel engines that can power any GA aircraft in the world. Continental Motors has had success throughout its history, but it finds itself today a different business addressing a changing market and an increasingly competitive landscape. The industry remains near the bottom established following the 2009 global economic downturn, during which our GA industry contracted by more than 60%. Even with the limited market potential to provide reasonable returns on investment, we are seeing growing competition from the other historical competitors, plus the entry of new players, all directed at taking market share as the size of the current market is not growing. Finally, the innovation first experienced with computers and the internet is now spilling over into our industry as billionaire tech entrepreneurs bring their money and nothing is impossible attitude to GA to stoke the development of innovative, environmentally friendly new aircraft designs. Change, competition, and innovation are exciting as it raises the spark of desire in us to remain a leader in this industry. We have advantages that others do not, including our long history, our people, our knowledge, a strong base in facilities, experience, and customers, and a strong owner that remains willing to invest. However, to remain relative and competitive, we have to advance faster and offer new and better technology solutions and satisfy ever more demanding customers. This requires resources, alignment, and teamwork on a global scale. Although our shareholder is willing to and has invested, they expect us to also contribute to the growth of our business. Our transformation began several years ago with the acquisitions and research investment. It accelerated as we began to leverage the skills of our different facilities to integrate duplicate capabilities under lean principles. Now we will enter the next phase of our multi-year strategy, a strategy that is aimed at freeing the resources needed to accelerate our technology investment manifold. I am pleased today to announce the Blue Marlin Project. We chose the Blue Marlin name because it represents one of the most sought after game fish in the ocean. It is a fish that once fully mature, has very few predators, is nimble, fast, and highly sought after. All attributes that we want to have as a company into the future. Blue Marlin program represents a funded, formal, multi-year program to modernize, harmonize, and internationalize our company. It is a program aimed at servicing ultimately our customers and providing us a lean, highly efficient operation that makes us more nimble than any of our competition in existence or coming into existence over the next few decades. Blue Marlin includes three key components that I am very excited today to talk about. Now, I know many of you understand because you've heard about this or heard the rumors that we're looking at establishing a new facility in a new location. Well, it's true. The first step in our journey is to establish a new, modern, lean manufacturing and office center that will replace the 11-building, 44-acre, 100-year-old facility that we currently occupy in Mobile, Alabama. Now, it is also true that we've looked at many locations. But at the end of the day, it comes down to some key factors in making a decision. The first and most important factor is always our employees and team members, the most valuable asset that any company can have. The second is the history that we have. So I am very pleased and excited today to tell you that we will establish this new modern lean manufacturing and office center in Mobile, Alabama, the United States of America. So the next facet of this program is to establish a harmonized global customer service capability that recognizes that our customers are moving beyond the typical markets where general aviation has been in the past. As we complete this portion of the program, we will have the capability to service our customers 24/7, 365 in multiple languages with phone, computer, internet, and app capability. The final step is to expand our presence into China. China represents the future market for high volume growth that will approximately $20 to $30 million worth of building investment into the community. Next, Continental Motors Group itself will make a direct investment of $40 million in new factory equipment and processes to outfit the building that is going to be built. This will allow us to modernize our operations, improve the overall efficiency of what we do, bring a level of manufacturing technology into our industry and into our particular operation that is not rivaled among the other general aviation piston engine manufacturers. And finally, we're very pleased to also state that we're investing in partnership with the state of Alabama, the city and county of Mobile, and the local support groups in the community to establish a dedicated training activity to ensure that all of our team members are fully trained on this new facility and the equipment and the operations that we will bring to bear so that we can ensure that their skill set is raised to the level that will make us a leader in the industry and mirrors what's being done within the Mobile community, both in its aerospace businesses as well as the broader industry that this community holds. This decision took a long time coming and did involve a global and a United States specific search for potential locations. At the end of the day, it came down to three key things. First and foremost was our team members that have given us a great part of their life and a lot of the skill that they have. It's always amazed me as I go out and meet my team members at how dedicated and how long they have served this company. Our average tenure among our employee base is almost 15 years. And I'm pleased to say that I have shaken the hands of people that have retired after 45, 49, and I look forward to shaking a gentleman who is nowhere near retirement, but who will have spent 50 years with the company this year. That kind of dedication needs to be rewarded. The next is the community. The community of Mobile embraced us a little bit over 50 years ago when we brought our company to this location in 1966. The community worked hard to make sure that we had what we needed to stay here and recognized the commitment that this company has made itself while also recognizing the commitment the community has made to us. And then finally, our shareholder, who when they bought us 6 years ago, agreed to invest in us then and has agreed to invest in us now as we modernize our operations to take us forward for another 100 years of company life. The ultimate outcome of this investment and this commitment of our team members and our community will be to allow us to free up resources to increase the pace of investment in research and development and new products that will benefit the general aviation industry and help the United States remain the leading exporter globally of this type of technology by allowing us to open up markets that don't just include China, but also include the Pacific Rim, India, Africa, and South America, all markets that are underserved broadly by general aviation.
Now, the final important thing to know is our project timeline has been slow getting to this point, but it begins an accelerated and aggressive pace. We expect to have our groundbreaking middle of this year. We expect to complete our full building design in the fall of 2017, and to see the building ready for us to start installing equipment and begin occupation in the fall of 2018, and we will be fully operational by 2019. Very aggressive, not as aggressive as some, but recognizes the type of environment and the dramatic change that we are going through as a company in bringing this to fruition. Now, we spoke to our team members earlier, and they're very excited about this and very supportive, but we also want to bring the community into this. So without further ado, I'd like to invite Mayor Stimson to the stage to say a few words on the level of commitment that they are giving and what this community means to us. Mayor, thank you very much.
Thank you. Rhett, I know that you and your team members across the globe are excited, but their excitement is not exceeded by ours, I assure you. With me today are Councilman C.J. Small. This is his district that we happen to be in, and John Williams. But even for those that are absent, I can assure you that we are grateful for what you've done. For over 50 years, Continental has been a great corporate citizen to our community, providing high-paid jobs to many of our citizens. And I would also say that you were here first. When this place was abandoned and we were looking for somebody to come and take over some of the abandoned warehouses and hangars that we had, you showed up. And the commitment that Continental is making right now, well, I don't know how many years it will go into the future, but you may be teed up so that you could be the last also. So we're definitely excited about what you're doing. Now, this is a great deal for our city, because it's a reflection of the good things that are going on in our community, but also the skill level of the workforce that we have in Mobile. You know, at this facility, we already have some of the most highly skilled workers in the state of Alabama, and as it goes forward, I can say that I believe that you will have the most highly skilled workers in the state of Alabama once Project Blue Marlin is completed. Again, this just reflects the trajectory for our city, of the workforce, the commitment that we have, not only from the city of Mobile, but also the county and the state, and the collaboration that we have in working to make sure that our corporate citizens feel welcome to our community, and that we will do everything that we can to make sure that you're successful. So I want to thank the leadership of Continental for their commitment in Mobile, and we look forward to working with you, and we wish you the most success. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mayor. It's a sentiment that we agree with fully. Now, we would also like to invite Commissioner Ludgood up, representing the County of Mobile, to help us understand the commitment that we've all seen from the county as well.
Good afternoon. On behalf of the Mobile County Commission, which includes Commissioners Connie Hudson and Jerry Carl, who is here, we welcome you to this event that just signals another milestone in our five-decade relationship with Continental Motors in Mobile County. During those years, Continental has provided well-paying jobs that have enabled its employees to purchase homes and to educate their children and to provide opportunities for their families they might have not otherwise have been able to do so. Continental has made significant investments in growing its presence here, and even greater investments in the lives of our residents. We are honored that you have planted deep roots here and have worked so diligently to grow and retain jobs for those who call Mobile County home. We appreciate your commitment, and the County Commission stands ready to assist in any way we can as together we work to help grow our economy. Thanks so much, and congratulations on this occasion.
Thank you, Commissioner. So educating and training our team members to ensure that they have the best skills possible is key to our success. Continental Motors has partnered with the local community and the state to make this possible for our company. Next, I'd like to introduce Mr. Ed Castile, Director of AIDT, to say a few words.
Well, good morning. It is a great day here in Mobile, and you know, it takes a team to do something like this, for sure. It takes a great workforce. It takes a trained workforce, but it also takes good leadership. President Ross and a good team from the management team here, obviously the workers, but the commitment and the dedication, of course, the investment in the community. So we thank you for all of that, especially, and congratulate you on the expansion, number one, and certainly the decision to do it here in Mobile. And as it's been pointed out several times, this is a long-time neighbor. I mean, these guys have been providing jobs here for the last 50 years, and as the mayor said, probably the next 50 and beyond. And for those kinds of investments, we in the state of Alabama, and Mobile in particular here, are very fortunate. Bring greetings from Governor Bentley, from Secretary Canfield, and we're just extremely pleased to be a partner in this. The training of our workforce is especially when you're building something so intricate as these engines, and I don't know if you had a chance, but if you haven't, look at these products. It's very impressive. And of course, when we're flying up there, we really want those things to work right? So we got to have the right we got to have the right equipment, the right people, and the training, and of course the attitude, work ethic, and ability to get that technology put together and in that airplane. But it takes a team, and these guys wouldn't have made this investment if they weren't confident in the workforce, if they weren't confident in their 50 years of being here already. But it takes a team. The mayor's office, the city council, the county commission, all here, and of course the Mobile Chamber of Commerce, Bill Sisson, Troy, and a team from the chamber, the airport authority that's here, Team Alabama, Bob Smith, I know one of our commerce project managers who worked on this project is here as well, and it takes all of us to work together to help companies like this make these kinds of investments in Alabama. We're proud to be, a partner, and we're especially proud that these products are going to be made in Alabama. Thank you.
Now, as Mike said, training is very important, but also a partnership with the airport is equally important. And we've been here for 50 years. It amazed me when I came here what I saw. And I can tell you that the transformation in the airport, led by the Airport Authority, has been phenomenal. We are now, I believe, one of the leading desirable aerospace corridors in the nation. And it's all centered around the Mobile Aeroplex at Brooklee. So without further ado, I'd like to ask the chairman of the board of the Mobile Airport Authority, Elliot Mazel, to come up and say a few words.
Good afternoon. It's a privilege and honor to be here representing the Mobile Airport Authority. The authority is really excited that today has finally come after years of hard work and collaboration. We've done everything we can to assure Continental that we're their guy. We want you to stay here, and we'll do everything in our power to see that the experience of constructing this fantastic facility goes as smoothly as possible. And I'm here to personally pledge on behalf of the authority and the city of Mobile, the great state of Mobile, that we'll be a great partner for Continental, just as we have for the past 50 years, And we thank you very much for your confidence in us. We will justify it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Mazel. So as we stated a number of times, we are very proud of our long history and strong relationship with the local community. This partnership is one of the main reasons that we have decided to continue our investment in the city of Mobile. Next, I'd like to introduce Mr. Bill Sisson, President and CEO of the Mobile Chamber of Commerce, to say a few words.
Well, good afternoon. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Rhett. Certainly appreciate that. And on behalf of the Chamber's Board of Directors and Advisors, our Chair, Liz Freeman, who is here, and our more than 2,000 members, business members of our organization representing over 100,000 employees, we appreciate Continental Motors' continued investment in Mobile and for being such an important part of this business community. And we specifically appreciate your investment here at the Mobile Aeroplex, really the center of our burgeoning aviation aerospace business sector. Continental, as has been said, has been a stalwart supporter of this community from the very beginning for decades, and we appreciate your continued investment and advancement of the Mobile economy. You have also been a long-time investor in our Partners for Growth program, which is in team fashion. All of those members are here today. We work together to grow this economy in all business sectors, including the aviation and aerospace sector, so we appreciate that support. And in closing, I really would like to especially thank our Chamber Economic Development team led by Troy Wayman, and in particular, David Rogers, who worked this project. Good guys, good work, guys. And again, Continental, Rhett, Mike, we appreciate your believing in Mobile. It means a lot to us, and I'm really convinced that the best is yet to come in this community, and clearly you feel the same way. So it's a beautiful day for us to celebrate. So let's do just that. Again, congratulations.
Well, we really thank everybody for coming. We know that there may be a few questions. We thank everybody for supporting us, the community, the city, the state, the county, the Mobile Airport Authority, and all the others. We couldn't do it. We also thank the local community of businesses that have supported us. It's been amazing, the growth, the commitment, the sharing and support across that community. So with no further ado, I'll let anybody, if you have questions, we're happy to take them now. Yes, sir.
Giving them new kinds of products. And I was wondering if you could expand upon that a little bit. Are we looking at new engines for GA, or are we looking at new kinds of products altogether?
I think it's a little bit of both. Obviously, we are a leader in engine technology. We were the first to truly successfully get FADEC on a gasoline engine in, flying certified and commercialized. We did the same thing again when we brought the diesel technology to market. We're the first company that has actually been able, with our sister division in Germany, to successfully commercialize a diesel engine and have it flying in a very large multi-thousand unit fleet. We see in the short term additional engine technology of that type, both diesel and gasoline, that will come, including our new CD300 diesel. We see probably a move back to electronic engine controls as another example. But the other side where we really want to make an innovation for this industry is we see that different power systems are going to be necessary. We don't necessarily see maybe a decade or two from now that we're making direct drive propeller aircraft engines like you see on either side of me. We could see a much more electrified aircraft, much like we've seen electrified ships in the Navy and the commercial fleets. This increases the flexibility and opportunity for a number of reasons in aircraft design. That's an area that we want to lead in for our product range.
other areas that we could see innovation is in how we help the customer. If you look at what many other segments of the industry have done, using the power of the internet, connected devices and other stuff, these are areas that we're also looking. We are very serious when we say that we have to revolutionize our customer service mindset with respect to the flying GA public, because the next generation of GA pilot, I keep telling people, is going to be like me. They don't want to know how it works. They just want to know that it works, and they want it as easy as possible. That's what we've got to deliver. This investment starts to free up our brightest minds from running a factory to developing that type of technology. Sure. I can't see him hiding by.
Dave Hirschman, AOPA, I was just curious in job numbers, how many employees does Continental have now here in Mobile, and is this expected to change the employment base here?
It's a good question. Currently, Continental in the Mobile County specific area has slightly over 400 employees. In the South Alabama area, we have a little bit over 430 employees, because we do have a facility in just across the bay. We expect this to shift our employment. Part of our commitment to the community for doing this is not dropping below 300, but we don't expect any change in employment in the foreseeable future with the factory and the investments that we're making.
Is the facility in Fairhope, is that going to change? Is that going to be part of the new facility that you're building, or are you going to combine those, or are they going to remain separate?
They will remain separate because they're two totally different business GA business segments. Mobile is our global corporate headquarters and our main factory. The Fairhope operation is a maintenance, repair, and overhaul and FBO center, part of our services business. That business encompasses over 60 employees globally, but it's focused strictly on maintenance, repair, and overhaul of GA piston and turboprop aircraft. Any other questions? Wow, you guys are easy. Compared to my employees, they were hard. Well, we appreciate your time today. All of us will be around for a little while yet and are happy to answer any questions you may have one-on-one. Also, the various folks from the city, county, and state will be here for a few more minutes if you have questions or need to chat with them. And we also have some refreshments and light hors d'oeuvres. Please take them with you, otherwise I have to eat them. Thank you now.
Continental Motors began manufacturing engines in 1904 in the United States. Its early business focused on truck and car engines, but in 1906 it started to branch out with the initial investigation and design of an aircraft engine, the O-45. By 1927, the company got serious about aviation, starting the development of both the A-70 radial gas engine and the A-40 horizontally opposed gas engine. These engines were relatively unsophisticated and low in horsepower, but they were the foundation that established Continental as a leader for more than 90 years in the general aviation industry. The company has powered every iconic brand of aircraft, including Cessna, Beechcraft, Piper, Cirrus, Diamond, Mooney, and more. We have also been the undisputed leader in innovation, bringing fuel injection, turbocharging, and electronic engine controls to general aviation. Our success was best exemplified when we were chosen to power the first nonstop, non-refueled flight around the world as part of the 1986 Voyager aircraft program. In 2011, the company was purchased by Avic International Holding Company of Beijing, China. This acquisition was timely and beneficial as it brought a new parent with a long-term vision and a willingness to operate locally and invest in the future. Almost immediately, the company and leadership team were challenged to develop a long-term vision and to investigate new technologies. The result of this effort was a steady pace of investment in strategic acquisitions and new product development. In 2013, Continental Motors acquired the assets of Tillard Aircraft Company, adding a successful aviation diesel engine technology to our portfolio. Two MRO businesses, Southern Avionics and United Turbine, were added to the services business in early 2015. The company finished 2015 with the addition of the assets of Danbury Aerospace to bring the Titan line of PMA parts and engines into Continental Motors. Today, Continental Motors is the only aviation piston engine manufacturer with a full line of gasoline and diesel engines that can power any GA aircraft in the world. Continental Motors has had success throughout its history, but it finds itself today a different business addressing a changing market and an increasingly competitive landscape. The industry remains near the bottom established following the 2009 global economic downturn, during which our GA industry contracted by more than 60%. Even with the limited market potential to provide reasonable returns on investment, we are seeing growing competition from the other historical competitors, plus the entry of new players, all directed at taking market share as the size of the current market is not growing. Finally, the innovation first experienced with computers and the internet is now spilling over into our industry as billionaire tech entrepreneurs bring their money and nothing is impossible attitude to GA to stoke the development of innovative, environmentally friendly new aircraft designs. Change, competition, and innovation are exciting as it raises the spark of desire in us to remain a leader in this industry. We have advantages that others do not, including our long history, our people, our knowledge, a strong base in facilities, experience, and customers, and a strong owner that remains willing to invest. However, to remain relative and competitive, we have to advance faster and offer new and better technology solutions and satisfy ever more demanding customers. This requires resources, alignment, and teamwork on a global scale. Although our shareholder is willing to and has invested, they expect us to also contribute to the growth of our business. Our transformation began several years ago with the acquisitions and research investment. It accelerated as we began to leverage the skills of our different facilities to integrate duplicate capabilities under lean principles. Now we will enter the next phase of our multi-year strategy, a strategy that is aimed at freeing the resources needed to accelerate our technology investment manifold. I am pleased today to announce the Blue Marlin project. We chose the Blue Marlin name because it represents one of the most sought-after game fish in the ocean. It is a fish that, once fully mature, has very few predators, is nimble, fast, and highly sought after. All attributes that we want to have as a company into the future. Blue Marlin program represents a funded, formal, multi-year program to modernize, harmonize, and internationalize our company. It is a program aimed at servicing ultimately our customers and providing us a lean, highly efficient operation that makes us more nimble than any of our competition in existence or coming into existence over the next few decades. Blue Marlin includes three key components that I am very excited today to talk about. Now, I know many of you understand, because you've heard about this or heard the rumors, that we're looking at establishing a new facility in a new location. Well, it's true. The first step in our journey is to establish a new, modern, lean manufacturing and office center that will replace the 11-building, 44-acre, 100-year-old facility that we currently occupy in Mobile, Alabama. Now, it is also true that we've looked at many locations. But at the end of the day, it comes down to some key factors in making a decision. The first and most important factor is always our employees and team members, the most valuable asset that any company can have. The second is the history that we have. So I am very pleased and excited today to tell you that we will establish this new modern lean manufacturing and office center in Mobile, Alabama, the United States of America. So the next facet of this program is to establish a harmonized global customer service capability that recognizes that our customers are moving beyond the typical markets where general aviation has been in the past. As we complete this portion of the program, we will have the capability to service our customers 24/7, 365, in multiple languages with phone, computer, internet, and app capability. The final step is to expand our presence into China. China represents the future market for high volume growth that will really challenge us as a business. So we will establish a new engineering development and technical support center that will put us on the forefront of the new OEMs and new opportunities that that market represents. The Blue Marlin journey will start today. It represents a nearly 3-year program. It will result in a new modern manufacturing and office center in Mobile, Alabama. It will allow us to invest and establish a global customer service capability operating on multiple continents that gives us capability in our segment second to none. And finally, it will free up resources so that we can accelerate our technological development so that we can be responsive to the future desires of general aviation power systems globally, as well as being nimble enough to meet the rapid growth in the China and global general aviation market. Now, change is exciting but difficult. We all must understand that when we complete the Blue Marlin journey 3 years from now, that no team member and no location will conduct business or operations as we do it today. If we do this well and embrace this, we will come out at the top of our industry 3 years from now and be prepared as a lean, efficient, and nimble company to respond to both the technological needs and the business needs of the general aviation market in the global environment. I look forward to experiencing the Blue Marlin journey with you. Our leadership team is here to answer any questions you may have today and throughout the entire project. I appreciate your time and wish you a good day. Thank you.